In this lecture, we will take up a very interesting problem where a cylinder is rolled not on the flat surface but on the series of the rollers. There are series of rollers of very small diameter and they are equidistant. The distance is L between each roller and this is the radius of the cylinder, and it is also given that the L is very, very small as compared to R. So what is happening in this problem? In this problem, we have to pull it with certain force so that it moves with a constant velocity. It is also given that every time the impact is made by the cylinder with the rods here, that is inelastic. So impact here is inelastic, means it is not bouncing and it is inelastic. Inelastic again would mean that we are losing some energy out of it. Now, how much energy is lost? There is an interesting relationship between the energy lost and the direction in which the impact is inelastic. Let me cover that basic thing first. It's very useful. Take, for example, a case where a ball or a circular spherical object strikes a wall and it goes at a certain angle. It strikes at an angle theta but goes at an angle phi because of the coefficient of restitution is not 1, means it's not an elastic collision. It will not rebound at the same angle. It will rebound at a different angle where phi will be greater than theta. And in another lecture I have already derived tan phi is 1 upon e tan theta, where e is coefficient of restitution. So I am not dealing with the derivation of that formula. I am dealing with a different thing right now. What I am trying to show you is that when there is an incoming object with a velocity v and it is rebounding at a certain angle and going back at a velocity va, and when there is a coefficient of restitution which is not 1, means there is a loss of energy. Where is that loss of energy? What is the cause of that loss of energy? Just try to understand that. First of all, we should know that in case of such collisions where a spherical object strikes, say, another cylindrical object, the reaction is always perpendicular to the line of contact. Like here, this is a cylindrical object, this is again a cylindrical object. So the point of contact is like this. So the point of contact, if you draw tangent, so reaction is always along the tangent through the point of contact. And in case of flat surface, if you have a cylinder or a sphere striking, then this is the point of contact. So reaction will be always along the point of contact. And if it is given that there is no rough surface and all, if these surfaces are smooth, there is no force perpendicular to this reaction. Here it is the horizontal force, which will not be existing. Here, the force perpendicular to the point of contact will not exist. No force will be there perpendicular to the line of contact, means the action of contact, until unless it is given in the problem. Now here also, whatever force is acting on the ball is because of this reaction, which is normal. There is no force acting perpendicular to the action, means perpendicular to the point of contact. Perpendicular from the point of contact, if you draw a normal and perpendicular to it, there is no force acting in this direction. So what will happen? You can conserve the momentum along x. If this is x axis, you can write mv sine theta is equal to mva sine phi, or v sine theta is va sine phi. Now I'll show you an interesting thing. I'm doing it just to show an interesting result. Suppose I write initial energy and final energy. Initial energy is half mv square. Final energy is half mva square. This is multiplied by 1. This is also multiplied by 1. I can write cos square theta plus sine square theta. Here I can write cos square phi plus sine square phi. No difference is made. Now, what is the change in energy? Is just subtract this from this is half m common v square cos square theta plus v square sine square theta minus v a square cos square phi minus v a square sine square phi. This is equal, v sine theta is v a sine phi, so this will get cancelled. So my loss of energy is only because of this v square cos square theta minus v a square cos square phi. So the loss of energy is only because of the velocity components which are along this v cos theta is incoming and v a cos phi is the when it is going back. So these are just reflective of the components of velocity along the direction of the reaction. So I lose that much energy. If it is a completely inelastic kind of a thing, then I will lose almost completely. This will be zero, then the whole component, incoming component, which was v cos theta. If there is no vertical rebound, if the ball goes horizontally like this, then this is zero. If the ball goes at 90 degree, means it doesn't rebound, it goes straight. So this is zero. Then the whole initial share of velocity which was along this is lost. This is what I want to say. So in case of such inelastic collisions where there is no rebound, means it doesn't rebound, the whole share of the velocity, the kinetic energy corresponding to that component of velocity which is along the action, means along the reaction line where you are having reaction. So if this, like some object is striking here and it had this velocity at the time of impact, and I say this is inelastic, then my this component, if this angle is alpha and this is v cos alpha will get the energy corresponding to v cos alpha, means half m v cos alpha whole square will vanish. That much energy I will lose. Now I'll use this concept in solving this problem, because here what is happening is that the collision is given as inelastic, means you are losing energy, but you have to pull this cylinder at a constant velocity despite the fact that you are losing the energy. So what is happening is that there is some loss of energy, and I have to recover that energy, I have to provide that energy in terms of work done in each cycle. Now each cycle is corresponding to distance L. Just see, take from here, suppose any point, if the height is R, means the cylinder was somewhere here initially, this is the beginning of cycle, this is end of cycle, and this is the middle of cycle. In the middle of cycle, cylinder comes like this here. Same thing I have drawn at a different location so that it becomes very, doesn't become very clumsy. So when this angle is theta by 2, theta, or this is theta, the whole angle will be twice theta. So this is the middle point, and the next point will be when it goes to this other. This way it completes the entire cycle of L, means it is first at this height, then in the middle, means here, and then again at this height. So you see the center of mass is falling and again going back. So it is like this one cycle, this is L, another cycle. So center of mass in every cycle, center of mass is falling by a certain height h, which we can easily calculate from trigonometry. And when it is in case of ideal situation where elastic collisions are there, if something loses the potential energy on rebounding, it should gain that much of potential energy, it should reach back. But here, since the reactions are not elastic, means the collisions are not elastic, so energy is being lost. What is the energy which is being lost? How much is the height? Let us calculate both of them. First, let us calculate what is this height. Just see in this diagram, this is the initial R, and here it has come like this. In the half cycle, it has come like this, and this is the direction of the velocity. This angle is theta. You take this. This is how much? This is r. This whole distance is r. So this much distance I can write as, this is theta, this is r cos theta. This much distance is r cos theta. Or I can solve in this triangle. If I write this as height h, then in this triangle it is like this. This is r, this is r minus h, and this is l by 2. This is l by 2, this is l by 2. So just solve in this triangle, r square is equal to r minus h whole square plus l square upon 4. Or you can write r minus h whole square is equal to r square 1 minus l square upon 4r square. Or you can write it as 1 upon 2. And do the binomial expansion, you get r minus h is equal to r 1 minus l square upon 8r square. So you get h is equal to l square upon 8r. Is the value of my height which I come down every time. Now when I come to this height, just see in this diagram, when I come here, if this is the velocity with which it is moving, I am saying we are moving it with a constant velocity. So velocity at the top point I always take as v. So initial energy is mv square. Energy at the midpoint of the cycle will be half m. Suppose that velocity is va square, and the mgh is added here, because here it is potential energy. Is that mgh? It has a higher height like this. This is the half cycle. This is that l by 2. Here this height is h and velocity is v, and here the velocity is va. So this equation I write. So I can write va square is equal to v square 1 plus twice gh upon v square. I have just rearranged that expression. I have cancelled m, multiplied by 2, and taken v square common. So it becomes va square is equal to v square 1 plus twice gh upon v square. Now this is the direction of va at this point of time. See the direction of va. If you see, if I draw the diagram again in a bigger scale, let me draw. So these are the rods, and here you have this cylinder. It is like this somewhere. It is like this. And here it has come, and this was the initial height. This is r. Here it was. I'm not drawing. Center was here, and center from here it has come here. And it is coming in this path, so this is the direction of velocity. Now just complete this triangle. It is like this. It is L upon 2. It is L upon 2. It is theta. It is theta. Draw these angles also. This angle will be theta, and this angle will be also theta. This we take as straight nearly. It's an arc, but we take straight. And so theta is, first of all, L upon 2 upon r, approximate value. And sine theta is also taken as theta. Some approximation we do in physics, we have to do. Theta from here, this is approximately L, this is r. So theta, this is approximately L upon 2, sorry, L upon 2, this is r. So theta is L upon twice r. Now see, the direction of velocity will be along this path. It has just rotated like this. The center is just rotating. So it is, this was here, and it rotated about it, and this is the direction. So this will be the direction of VA, which is pi by 2 minus twice theta. Now this is the line of impact. This is the reaction line. Along this reaction, this is the reaction line, and this is inelastic. So whatever is my share of energy along this is lost. And what is that? Will be VA cos pi by 2 minus twice theta, which is Va sine twice theta, or I can write Va twice theta approximately. This is the projection of velocity on this, and energy equivalent to this is lost, means half m into twice theta Va square. This is the energy which I am losing. This is the energy which I am losing, and this is the energy which I should provide. This only, the energy which is lost, which should I should provide in this cycle, so that it is again able to go back to this height. Ideally, without loss of energy, it comes higher, it strikes, it would have gone back like this. But since there is some loss of energy, this is the loss of energy which has happened, this much energy I have to provide from outside, which will be equal to work done. So if F is the force which I am applying and L is the distance which is there in each cycle, F into L should be equal to this, half M into Va square into twice theta whole square. What is the value of twice theta? Is L upon R. Theta was L upon 2 divided by R, so twice theta is L upon R. So twice theta whole square means it is L square upon R square. So I get value of F is equal to 1 upon 2 M Va square L upon R square is the value of force, and put the value of Va here, so you get the answer. So the force is half M L upon R square, and what is Va square is V square 1 plus twice G upon V square, and what was value of H was L square upon 8 R square, and here L square upon 8 R, sorry, not 8 R square, it is 8 R, yes, and it is capital R. So this is the value. This is my answer also. This is the force which I have to apply so that the system moves with a constant velocity. The important point was the energy lost will be the in that proportion in which we have the velocity along the reaction.